Why is Emancipation Day celebrated in Jamaica? Emancipation Day, celebrated on the 1st of August each year in Jamaica, is a national holiday. Emancipation, by definition, though, really means freedom and liberation from oppression, constraints, inequity, and victimization. In our context, emancipation refers to the 1838 action of granting freedom to our foreparents who were the property of the plantation owners, the road to emancipation in Jamaica. If you know anything about the history of Jamaica, you'd have learned of the severe struggles our foreparents had to endure during slavery, getting here and working in the inhumane, cruel, and barbaric plantation system. It was brutal. But with resistance and continued lobbying, particularly between 1780 and 1838, by several anti-slavery champions, including persons like Thomas Clarkson, William Wilberforce, Joseph Sturge, William Knibb, Thomas Burchell, and Samuel Sharp, the colonial powers did the inevitable. The process bore fruit in 1807 with the abolition of the Atlantic slave trade, and then in 1833, on August 28, with the passing of the Abolition of Slavery Act. The Abolition of Slavery Act. But the Abolition of Slavery Act, by the way, also known as the Emancipation Act of 1833, was narrow and limited. For example, it stated that all, or only, children under 6 years of age should be set free, and there was to be a 6 years apprenticeship from 1834 to 1840 for everyone else. And by the way, the British Parliament also voted £20 million as compensation to the slaveholders in their empire. Of this amount, £5,853 million was the share that fell to the Jamaican slaveholders. But that did not go down well either. The apprenticeship. According to Rebecca Tortello in her article, The Road to Freedom, the tenets of apprenticeship stated that the ex-slaves would work without pay for their former masters for three quarters of every week in exchange for lodging, food, clothing, medical attendance, and provision grounds in which they could grow their own food during the remaining quarter of the week. They could also, if they choose, hire themselves out for more wages during that remaining quarter. With this money, an ex-slave turned apprentice could then buy his freedom. Overall, though apprenticeship proved confusing for the ex-slaves, they were told that they were free, but they were not really free. Indeed, for many, the quality of their lives had not undergone any great change. As a result, there was continued discontent followed by militancy. Full freedom. As a result, apprenticeship ended 2 years earlier, on August 1, 1838, than the intended six-year term in 1840. The British governor, Sir Lionel Smith, stood before a large crowd in Spanish Town, St. Catherine, which was then Jamaica's capital, and read the Proclamation of Freedom from Queen Victoria, and the Abolition Act came into effect. That day marked the day of full freedom, the first Emancipation Day celebration, the day our foreparents were finally made free. It was a rapturous day that August morning when they gathered in their villages and churches to rejoice and give thanks. We gained full right to work on our own account. Our children could no longer be taken at the master's pleasure. We were no longer faced the threat of the pain of the whip or the ultimate enforcement, death. We could settle lands and live in peace in our villages. Peaceful demonstrations and celebrations occurred across the island. A hearse containing shackles and chains that had been used to shackle rebellious slaves was driven through the streets of the capital's Spanish Town and ceremoniously burnt. Essentially, the system that classified us as property came to an end. When did emancipation become a holiday? Emancipation Day, August 1, was officially introduced as a public holiday in Jamaica in 1893. However, it was discontinued in 1962 when Jamaica gained independence, celebrated on August 6. Emancipation Day was, however, reinstated in 1997 by then Prime Minister Percival James P.J. Patterson as a national holiday celebrated on, yes, August 1. Independence Day was also fixed on August 6. So why do we celebrate emancipation in Jamaica? Why do we bother with this celebration? I think you got the point by now, but our then Prime Minister, Andrew Holness, in his 2018 address, answered the question by aptly stating, "The yearly emancipation celebrations give us an opportunity to reflect on the struggles of our ancestors for freedom against a system that denied them their dignity and humanity, often through brutally oppressive and violent means. And that time, it brought hope to our people. And that is the same idea today. This reflection is meant to bring renewed hope and inspiration to us, considering where we are coming from, where we are now, and what we need to do to create the future we desire, just as they did." In closing, we could argue that we have some way to go, and we probably do, with the political, social, and economic state the country is in. Despite some advancement, it is hard to argue. But this celebration is important to us as our Independence Day, because truly, as Marcus Mosiah Garvey says, a people without the knowledge of their past history, origin, and culture are like a tree without roots. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that this was inspiration to you. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I implore you to hit that subscribe button and tap the bell notification. I do a lot of videos like these, capturing the history, the heritage, the people, the personalities, the culture of my country, my island Jamaica, and I don't want you to miss any of that. So hit that subscribe button and tap the bell notification. That way, you'll see updated on all my latest videos. Happy Emancipendence!